morning, students. Now, as we are studying the chapter The Empire Across the Three Continents, as yesterday in your previous class, I had mentioned regarding about the Roman Empire. Roman Empire, we are going to study particularly about the Roman Empire, and this empire now extended and very vast area, very vast, or many of the, not only the countries or states, three continents, part of the three continents came under the control of the Roman Empire, and it extended on first the entire Mediterranean area was under this control of the Roman Empire, and moreover it was the extended in the north of the Africa. Its extension was in the North Africa, and its extension now or in the almost the most part of the Africa was under the control of the Romans, this vast Roman Empire, and as well as the Central Asia, the West Asians, certain parts also come under the control of the Roman Empire. The students, and I had already mentioned that the three Roman Empire had the three pillars: the monarch, senate, and army. These were the three pillars of the Roman Empire, and this vast Roman Empire. Now, to know about that, we depend to construct the history of the Roman Empire. Particularly, we depend on the particularly three kind of the sources. First sources, I had talked already about the texts. Second kind of the sources, I had told you documents, and third kind of the material remains. By the later on excavation, the archaeologist now dug out the sites of in the Roman Empire, and from those sites they got a lots of remains, or the information or fragments, which were much to tell about the history of the Romans. Understand? And amongst that, we find that pottery, coins, buildings, monuments, and other fragments now speaks about the Romans' history. Students, Rome was no doubt a vast continent or the empire, or is the Rome was its nucleus of this vast empire, Roman Empire, which was stretched in northern Egypt, northern Africa, and as well as in entire Mediterranean Sea, and the islands were under its control. Entire peninsulas was under its control, and Spain, and even the France, understand, and the rest of the European countries were under the control of the Romans. And in the east, we can see that its border now was adjacent to the Iranians and Persians borders up to there, and the entire of central and western Asia was under the control of the Romans. And this vast empire, scholars now give the opinion that the first time in this region, in the Roman Empire, the agriculture began in southern and northern Romans Empire, and where first time the southern, or it was the around the Italy, agriculture began in 7,000 years back, and the 6,000 BC year backs, and moreover, about the 2,000 year, Italy was inhabited by the several tribes. In the very beginning, में tribals यहाँ inhabitants थे, and they were living, and many of their Indo-Europeans origin or in of these tribes had their Indo-European origins, and moreover, two major of the Indo-European tribes to be the found in this area, and centers and the North Italy, Central and North Italy, and Etruscans. Etruscans were the main non-Indo-European people of the Italy, Etruscans, and they moreover now concentrated in the northwest Italy, and as well as the central Italy. They concentrated in this area. The use of irons also became the widespread in the Roman Empire. Almost it was the about the 8th century BC. Almost 8th century BC it was the began. And now around this, आप जानते हैं कि now iron brought a revolutionary change. क्योंकि after the bronze, iron is at the, because of the advent of the iron is, it was a itself a strong tools, strong weapons began to be the procured. And now, moreover, it was around the period there was a development of some new trends in this area inhabited by the Etruscans. And Etruscans were the first people who now started the urbanization. The urbanization, process of the urbanization began during them. And this was the one of the watermark in the growth of the Roman Empire. And now most of the advanced people of the pre-Roman Italy, or that is why this Etruscans began to be the known as the most advanced people of the Roman Empire, and moreover, they occupied the most of the central and the northwest frontiers of the Roman Empire, and finally, about the 800 to 700, and these peoples, the Latin Americans, the Latin speaking people, were around the Rome, or these Latin speaking people, and now they copied and they followed many of the cultures and even the language and the cultures of the Etruscans people. And now Latin speaking people territories west or central Asia frequently overlapped with the centers of the Etruscans, or ye dheere dheere Etruscans ke jo centers the उसे ओवरलैप करने लगे, और नाउ इटली नाउ इमर्ज एज अ लैटिन सिटी एंड बोरोड द सेवरल एलिमेंट्स. मैंने पहले भी कहा कि जो एज फ्रॉम द एस्टुकेंस द लैटिन स्पीकिंग पीपल दे नाउ ऑब्जर्व एंड दे नाउ लर्नड ए लॉट ऑफ नॉलेज फ्रॉम देम. दे वर यूजली इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाय देयर cultures. And now, and moreover, Romans located on the bank of the Tiber. Romans, since the this city itself was the situated on the Tiber River, Tiber, and it's as the very important for the Romans. And this traditionally, the Rome was founded by the two brothers. The two brothers, their name are Romulus and Romus. They were the two brothers, and these brothers say. Now founded in 753 BC, and the Etruscans family became the politically dominant in the city. ये जो Etruscans family था, they became the very much dominant, and moreover, पॉलिटिकल डोमिनेशन इन द सिटी, और धीरे धीरे स्टूडेंट्स का वहाँ पे पॉलिटिकल डोमिनेशन हुआ, यानी कि पॉलिटिकल सिस्टम दे नाउ एक्वायर। एंड मोर ओवर ट्रेडिशनली इट इज सेड दैट कि नाउ फाउंडेड बाय स्टूडेंट्स फैमिली बिकेम कंसिक्वेंटली द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ द रोम नाउ इज स्पीडेड अप, और उन्होंने इस तरह से इन दिस वे रोम की जो सभ्यता था या रोमन्स जो एक्सपेंशन था या स्ट्रेंथ था दैट दे बिगेन टू स्टडी, और मोनार्किकल फॉर्म ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट वॉज, एंड वन थिंग इज दैट दिस एस्टुकेंस फॉर्म द मोनार्किकल फॉर्म ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट। मोनार्किकल फॉर्म ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट इज दैट गवर्नमेंट इन विच द किंग्स नाउ वेस्ट द इंटायर पावर इन हिज हैंड्स, पावर इज नाउ वेस्टेड इन द किंग्स, किंग्स इज द इन द मोनार्किकल फॉर्म ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट किंग इज द ऑल इन ऑल, वेदर द एक्सिक्यूटिव लेजिस्लेटिव और जुडिशियर पावर वेस्ट इन द हैंड्स ऑफ द किंग। सो द मोनार्किकल सिस्टम ऑटोक्रेटिक मोनार्किकल सिस्टम बिगेन इन रोमन पॉलिटिक्स, एंड मोर ओवर और देन आफ्टर द रोम नाउ रोल्ड टूवर्ड्स द इट्स एक्सपेंशन इन द ऑल अराउंड, एंड दिस मोनार्किकल सिस्टम केम टू एब्रप्ट एंड इन द 510 BC द टार्क्विन द लास्ट रूलर ऑफ द किंग लास्ट रूलर वॉज ओवर थ्रोन एंड नाउ एंड विथ इट द एस्टुकेंस रूल ऑफ ओवर द रोमन केम टू एंड, और जो एस्टुकेंस का जो रूल था 510 BC में, अंडरस्टैंड टार्क्विन किंग जो इनका लास्ट रूलर था ही वॉज गिवेन द ए क्रशिंग डिफीट इन द बैटल, एंड बाई दैट by this their powers now came to an end, their rule was now vanished, and moreover after that time Rome and the Roman Republic was set up. 510 of year was a landmark in the history of Rome, understand, where Tarquin the last Etruscan's ruler was now he was defeated and overthrown, and monarchical system was completely overthrown, and a process of the republican form of the government began by that, and Roman Republic and this republic lasted for the centuries up to the from the 510 BC to the 27 BC. 510 BC से अगर देखा जाए राइट फ्रॉम देयर 27 BC, दिस इज द सो लॉन्ग एंड इट वॉज ड्यूरिंग दिस पीरियड नाउ सिटी स्टेट्स रोम ग्रीव इन टू द ह्यूज एंड पावरफुल एम्पायर, सिटी स्टेट रोम था नाउ पावरफुल एम्पायर, सिटी स्टेट्स नाउ बिगेन टू फ्लोरिश इन द रोम, एंड मोर इट अचीव्ड द एक्सपेंशन फॉर द सीरीज ऑफ वॉर्स एंड कॉन्फ्लिक्ट। अब नाउ the process of Roman to be appeared as a vast empire, now this process began, and this process was to be happened by the wars and by the conflicts. The first day, let's see, in the first day phase we shall divide the Roman expansion in the basically in two phases. We shall divide the first phase was lasted for 500 BC to 280 BC, first phase, and in the first phase Roman Empire and the Roman rulers now extended their empire around the Italy, within the Italy and adjacent to the Italy. The first their target was bring the entire Italian peninsula under their control. पहले एफर्ट्स में जितने भी इटालियन पेनिनसुला थे दैट वाज टू बी द कम, एंड इज द स्टार्टेड प्रोसेस बाय एस्टैब्लिशिंग सुप्रीम ओवर द सेंट्रल इटली, नाउ दे स्टार्टेड दिस प्रोसेस। नेक्स्ट बाय द 295 BC मोस्ट ऑफ द सेंट्रल इटली केम द अंडर द रोमन डोमिनेशन, मोस्ट ऑफ जितने भी इंटरनल जो इनका अपनी कंट्री था इटली का दैट केम under this, and thereafter Roman turned to attention to the Greek states. इसके बाद after that जो southern में ग्रीक स्टेट्स जो सिचुएटेड थी, ग्रीक आइलैंड्स और वहां पे ग्रीक स्टेट्स, तो दैट रोमन एम्पायर रूलर्स नाउ टर्न देयर अटेंशन टू कैप्चर दिस एरिया अंडर देयर कंट्रोल एंड मोर ओवर देयर आफ्टर टर्न एंड द ग्रीक स्टेट्स सदर ऑफ द सदर्न इटली कंपेल टू देम द रीऑर्गेनाइज रिकॉग्नाइज देयर सुजरेंटी देयर authority and their suzerainty, they were recognized. And moreover, thus the entire peninsula directly or indirectly came under the control of them. Or mana jaye to directly ho ya indirectly, puri jo southern Italy ka jo Greek or jo bhi peninsular tha area, that was controlled in the and taken under the control. नेक्स्ट जो फेज इसका होता है, सेकेंड फेज है एक्सपेंशन ऑफ मेन ऑब्जेक्टिव टू रोमन वॉज एक्सटेंड द रोमन इन्फ्लुएंस टू द मेडिटेरियन, मीन्स द रोमन एम्पायर रूलर्स वॉन्टेड टू एक्सपैंड टूवर्ड्स द मेडिटेरियंस, इंटायर मेडिटेरियंस एरिया, वास्ट मेडिटेरियन एरिया दे वॉन्टेड टू टेक एंड इट्स एडजेसेंट एंड इट्स कोस्टल एरिया दे वॉन्टेड टू टेक अंडर देयर कंट्रोल. So for this their controls, now they proceeded ahead and the republic expanded itself and substantially by the three Punic wars. Or yahan pe jo Carthaginians the aur inka puri Mediterranean, agar mane jaye ki west Mediterranean ka jo area tha ye, that was the under the Carthaginians, understand, Spain and or Africa or the western Mediterranean area was under the control of these Carthages. So now they had to fight or unhone long battle, three Punic wars ye fight kiye, jinhone just they confronted with Punics for the expansion and more during the, and this war lasted from between the 264 to the 146 BC के बीच में ये वॉर हुआ पूरी मेडिटेरियन इलाके में एरिया में टू कंट्रोल दिस एंड दस बिकेम एन एम्पायर द रोमन्स एस्टेब्लिश्ड देयर कंट्रोल ऑन द एंटायर इटालियन पेनिनसुला और इस तरह से रोमन्स में पूरे जो पेनिनसुलर इटालियन पेनिनसुलर था उस पर उन्होंने कंट्रोल किया एंड मोर ओवर यहाँ अगर देखा जाए Italian peninsula come under their control. Then after the France, they got make the control over the France, that was called the Gaul also, and moreover Egypt and the West Asia, Egypt and Africa was North Africa, particularly this zone was brought under the control, and Egypt also came under their control, and middle of the second, the entire Mediterranean were directly or indirectly came under the control of these people. And moreover, the entire Romans, this came, the empire registered a expansions of the during the last phase of the Republic, conquest of the warlords like, but during the last phase of the Republic, a battle began amongst the warlords. Warlords, they now involve in the battles of battle amongst them, the largest empire of the world. And Julius Caesar now made, and he made the many of the conquest or converted this as a largest war. Let's see, the Carthaginians was originally a Phoenicians trading settlements. Phoenicians ka trading settlements. And founded sometimes 9th century BC. Very soon it grew into the powerful states or included the large part of the western Mediterranean. जैसे मैंने कहा कि Carthaginians जो है ये पूरा Carthage थे ये और इन्होंने पूरी western Mediterranean Sea and included जिसमें कि Sicily जो कि now part of the Italy है, Spain, और Carthaginians located the North African coastal lines, the northern North Africa coastal. So without the having the victory over them, Italy, Romans could not एक्सपैंड एंड नाउ बोथ द स्टेट इज, और ये दोनों कार्थेजियंस जो स्टेट हैड द स्ट्रेटेजिक पॉइंट फ्रॉम द कमर्शियल पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से और मिलिट्री पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से, ये दिस वॉज द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एरिया. दैट्स वाई द रोमन वॉन्टेड एक्सटेंड देयर इन्फ्लुएंस ओवर द मेडिटेरियन, और फाइनली इट रिजल्टेड इन द कंफ्लिक्ट विद कार्थेजियंस एंड ए सीवियर वॉर, ए वेरी दे गस्ट इन टू द वॉर एंड बैटल द टू कार्थेजियंस एंड द रोमन्स. And as a result, Rome fought series of the battles against the Carthaginians, and now between the 264-46 Second Punic Wars, First Punic Wars was fought, Second Punic War was fought, and 218-201, and Third Punic War was fought between 149-46. एंड सेकेंड प्यूनिक वॉर्स वॉज द मोस्ट फ्यूरियस. जो सेकेंड प्यूनिक वॉर है ये मोस्ट रिमेम्बर, जस्ट वर्थ रिमेम्बरिंग है. क्यों? कि हनीबल एक ब्रिलियंट कमांडर था, हनीबल, और ही चैलेंज द रोमन एम्पायर. हनीबल वॉज द ब्रिलियंट कमांडर जनरल, डिस्प्लेड द वंडरफुल एक्सेप्शनल कैपेसिटी एंड स्किल or excellence of in the battle. And now as a result, he successfully crossed the high altitude alpine mountain. Isne alpine mountain ko cross kar gaya ye. And ultimately, and with his large army or enter into the north Italy. Ye kitna brave tha ki alpine mountains ko ek huge army ko lekar ye cross kar gaya. And now he reached it in the north Italy. And moreover, by the end of the third Punic War, the Carthaginian Empire had been the completed, or third Punic War, by that time, the Carthaginians now got defeat, and this finally, their power was gradually, power was just devoured and finished, and they were brought under the control of that. So, this is the, by this way, सिसिली और स्पेन और अफ्रीका का जो इलाका था, इट वॉज द ओन बाई द रोमन एम्पायर बाई डिफ्टिंग द कार्थेजियंस. ओके, और द वॉर, थ्री वॉर्स वॉज फाउट, इट इज द कॉल्ड एज द पुनिक वॉर्स. नेक्स्ट लेट्स सी, नाउ द रोम ब्रॉट मैसिडोनिया एंड द ग्रीक, ग्रीक और मैसिडोनिया बिल्कुल, and the states under the control. Macedonia was annexed by the Rome 147 mein, ek important state in Mesopotamia ko annex kiya, or the Greek states, thus the Greek states controlled by Macedonia. Aur is tarah se Macedonia ke through Greek states ko controlled and also came under the indirect rule of the Romans. Okay, Macedonia ke through ye other Greek states ko ye control karte the, aur Egypt was ruled by the टॉलमी डायनेस्टी, बिकेम द रोमन प्रोटेक्टरेट. और इजिप्ट जो था ये टॉलमी डायनेस्टी के थ्रू रूल होता था, टॉलमी डायनेस्टी थी. तो दे नाउ एक्सेप्टेड द सुजरेनिटी एंड दिस नॉर्थ अफ्रीका वॉज डिक्लेयर्ड एज अ प्रोटेक्टरेट. प्रोटेक्टरेट इट मीन्स दैट कि नाउ दे दैट स्टेट had its autonomy, the king of that states will remain intact, it will be the not annexed finally, but that state would not protect, a protected state, jo protectorate state hai wo kisi other se state ke sath wo koi diplomatic alliance nahi kar sakta without the permission of the विदाउट द परमिशन ऑफ ए रोमन. एक कोई भी प्रोटेक्टेड स्टेट होता है तो दैट इज द सपोज टू बी द स्मॉल, और जो बिग स्टेट्स जो होते हैं वो स्मॉल स्टेट्स को अपना एक प्रोटेक्टेड स्टेट बनाते हैं अंडर देयर एक प्रोटेक्टेड स्टेट. जैसे फॉर एग्जाम्पल ये भूटान, भूटान क्या है, भारत का एक प्रोटेक्टेड स्टेट है। तो कोई भी इसकी जो इंटरनेशनल जो पॉलिटिक्स है दैट वुड बी द कंप्लीटली कंट्रोल्ड बाय इंडिया, अंडरस्टैंड। तो ये प्रोटेक्टेड स्टेट से दैट वाज द नॉर्थ अफ्रीका वाज मेड अ प्रोटेक्टेड स्टेट्स एंड मोर ओवर नाउ द फॉरेन पॉलिसी वाज कंट्रोल्ड एंड वेस्टर्न एनाटोलिया आल्सो कम अंडर द रोमन रूल्स एंड दस मिडिल ऑफ द सेकेंड सेंचुरी बी सी द इंटायर मेडिटेरियन वॉज डायरेक्टली और इनडायरेक्टली नाउ ब्रॉट अंडर द कंट्रोल ऑफ देम। ओके, द नेक्स्ट वी आर गोइंग द से हियर द रिपब्लिक स्ट्रगल ऑफ वारलॉर्ड्स एंड द सीनेट। मैंने पहले भी कहा था, आपसे डिस्कस किया कि नाउ रिपब्लिक ये स्ट्रगल वॉज गोइंग बिटवीन द थ्री एलिमेंट। तो वहां की पॉलिटिक्स में थ्री एलिमेंट्स वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग थे, थ्री। बट विच द थ्री एलिमेंट्स, द थ्री एलिमेंट्स वेयर द सीनेट, वॉरलॉर्ड्स, कमांडर्स थे, वॉरलॉर्ड्स थे एंड द आर्मी। दिस दे प्लेड द वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल। तो सो फॉर ए लॉन्ग टाइम नाउ द रोमन एम्पायर वॉज क्लैक्ट विथ द इंटरनल वॉर्स और द इंटरनल डिस्टर्बेंस एंड मोर। मोर ओवर वी कैन सी द फर्स्ट ड्यूरिंग द लास्ट 100 years ऑफ द एक्सटेंशन और एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ द रोमन एम्पायर देयर वॉज ऑकर्ड सम यूनिक चेंजेस देयर। मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट ऑफ दिस वॉज द क्रिएशन ऑफ अ प्रोफेशनल्स आर्मी। इन्होंने रोमन्स ने अपने वास्ट स्टेट पर विक्ट्री करने के लिए प्रोफेशनल्स आर्मी बनाया, वेरी डायनेमिक आर्मी एंड वॉज द क्रिएशन ऑफ द प्रोफेशनल आर्मी हुआ इंडिविजुअल। और ये जो प्रोफेशनल आर्मी तैयार किए गए, प्रिपेयर किए गए, तो दे वेयर अंडर द कंट्रोल ऑफ द कमांडर्स और दिस कमांडर्स वेयर वेरी दे हैड द दे वेयर वेरी एस्पिरेंट। दिस कमांडर्स वेयर एम्बिशियस, इनकी बहुत हाई एम्बिशंस होते थे एंड दिस आर्मीज हैड टू बी द टोटल लॉयल्टी टू देयर कमांडर्स। दिस आर्मीज वेयर नॉट लॉयल टुवर्ड्स द सीनेट, सीनेट की तरफ लॉयल्टी नहीं थी और द दे हैड द कंप्लीट लॉयल्टी टुवर्ड्स द towards their commanders and commanders often would lead the campaigns in order to their personal gains। और जो भी commanders ये campaigns करते थे या किसी battle के expeditions पे ये जाते थे whenever they, तो now where तो most of they उनका अपना vested interest होता था for accumulating the wealth। कहीं भी लड़ाई पे गया, whatever they got during the battle, in the course of the battles, so now they acquired, and they acquired the wealth, this process, and they increased their powers, enter into the conflict with the each others. Iske baad, these commanders now involve in their own battles with the commanders, they jealous of each others, and they and for the competing acquiring the more power, becoming the more powerful, so these commanders now got involved into the battles and moreover there was several powerful commanders in that Roman empires mein bahut se commanders mein, amongst them the Marius, Sulla, Julius Caesar, Pompey or Mark Antony, these were the and Augustus, great commanders worth a description। ये बहुत बड़े commanders हुए in the life of the Romans in the empire। And now this is from the period between 100 BC to 2700, 100 BC say from that 2700 BC, these commanders and this period was period of the conflict to establishing their power and authority। Commanders say themselves now involved in this battle, the military leaders with large well trained armies now under them could violently asserted themselves for controlling the Roman state. और ये सभी चाहते थे रोमन स्टेट को कंट्रोल करना 100 BC, right from 100 BC to the 27 BC. They wanted to control the power and started their power and began to exercise their power with the huge army under their control. And amongst that, the army was now increasingly used for suppressing the discontent and promoting the interest of their commanders. और ये aristocracy और this army was fighting or being used for the interest of aristocratic class. And thus powerful military commanders and the warlords began to establish the respective control on Roman Empire. और ये धीरे धीरे Roman Empire पर अपनी control को establish करना शुरू किया. Moreover, Roman Empire violent conflict, warlords contributed significant speeding of collapse of the republic. और धीरे धीरे republics once it was the very the most regarded system. Gradually it began to lose its started losing its influence and the losing its control over the and republic was now denoted by the Senate of the Senate. बहुत पावरफुल थी रोम में, लेकिन ग्रेजुअली क्या हुआ कि रिपब्लिक और ये कमांडर्स क्या हुए कि ग्रेजुअली ये स्ट्रॉन्गर होते चले गए. ऑल्दो दे नेवर डिसमेंटल एंड डिसॉल्व द रिपब्लिक डिसॉल्व द सीनेट, लेकिन फिर भी अपनी पावर्स को इन्होंने एक्सर्ट किया और इन्फ्लुएंस रखा अपने वहाँ के पोलिटिकल सिस्टम में. एंड मोर ओवर Republic Senate, Roman Senates tried to curb the power of the Pompey. Pompey was one of the commanders, and now he spread. He became the very powerful, strengthened his power, and the Senate kai baar or leading warlords and two other warlords. They were very aspirant and they were very ambitious. Usko crush karne ke liye, for crushing them, the Senate ne apne ट्राई किया पॉम्पी को एंड द वॉरलॉर्ड्स के, बट जूलियस सीजर एंड द क्रेसस से कुड नॉट सक्सीड. लेकिन जूलियस सीजर और क्रेसस सक्सीड नहीं हुए, एंड दिस वाज मेनली बिकॉज द आर्मी वाज अंडर द कंट्रोल ऑफ दीज वॉरलॉर्ड्स. और ऐसा ही इसलिए हुआ कि आर्मी वाज अंडर द कंट्रोल ऑफ वॉरलॉर्ड्स. द टसल बिटवीन द सीनेट एंड द वॉरलॉर्ड्स रिजल्टेड ए सीरियस पोलिटिकल क्राइसिस. इससे क्या हुआ कि एक पोलिटिकल एनार्की हो गया, एक पोलिटिकल क्राइसिस हो गया कि हु विल होल्ड द पावर, वेदर द सीनेट और दीज वॉर लॉर्ड्स. अंडर दिस सर्कमस्टांसेस इटली एज रोम जस्ट बिगेन टू पास और अल्टीमेटली नाउ पोम्पी जूलियस सीजर एंड क्रेसस ज्वाइन द हैंड्स टू ओवर द टू टेक ओवर द रोमन स्टेट. इसलिए क्रेसस एंड जूलियस सीजर और पोम्पी ने एक अलायंस बनाया, इन्होंने एक ज्वाइंट कन्फ्रंट्रेशन बनाया टू टेक ओवर द पावर ऑफ द सीनेट और वहाँ की पूरी रोमन पावर्स को कैप्चर करने के लिए. एंड दे फॉर्म द कोलिशन, एक कोलिशन बनाया इन्होंने, एक फोर्स किया. एंड नाउ अल्टीमेटली दिस कोलिशन इज कॉल्ड एज द फर्स्ट ट्रायम्विरेट. First triumvirate. It means that triumvirate signifies the authority was equally divided among the three. Triumvirate का mean होता है कि authority was equally divided among the three. It means that they jointly wanted to form the government and rule over the Roman Empire. That's why to grab the power. Understand? They form the triumvirate. And now, ultimately divided among the three, entire authority of Roman concentrated in hands of the triumvirate. और पूरी जो रोमन concentration था जो authority का in the triumvirate. And ultimately the other institutions of the republic were not abolished, but they were made ineffective. दूसरे institutions को एवरेज नहीं किया, फाइनली हटाया नहीं गया, लेकिन उनके इफेक्ट को खत्म कर दिया गया, उसकी डोमिनेशंस को। एंड मोर ओवर द क्रेसस से, अब इसी में आगे सीरीज ऑफ इंसिडेंट्स क्या होता है कि क्रेसस बैटल नॉर्दर्न अफ्रीका में, बैटल मेसोपोटामिया में, सॉरी, वेयर वहां पे वो डेथ कर जाता है। ही वाज किल्ड इन द बैटल 50 और लास्ट है आफ्टर दिस बैटल पॉम्पी एंड जूलियस सीजर बिकेम द टेंस ऑफ देयर स्ट्रगल ऑफ द पावर, फुल फ्लेज सिविल वॉर स्टार्टेड। लेकिन आफ्टर द क्रेसस के डेथ के बाद ओनली द टू पार्टनर्स रिमेन, जूलियस सीजर एंड पॉम्पी, एंड दिस देयर फ्रेंडशिप एंड कॉलूशन टर्न इंटू एंड द चेंज इंटू द बिटर राइवल्स, दे बिकेम बोथ ऑफ देम एंड राइवल्स, एंड अल्टीमेटली इन दिस राइवलरी नाउ पॉम्पी वॉज गिफ्टेड फाइनली इन 1448 BC, he was the completely defeated by the Julius Caesar, or he escaped and took shelter in the Egypt, where later on he was assassinated. Pompey, now he fled and took the refuge in North Africa, Egypt, or jahan pe uski hatya kar di gayi. And moreover, now Julius Caesar was supreme lord of the Rome. Julius Caesar now ascended, and or in 1448 BC or became the dictator with the, ye kaha jata hai ki now he became the dictator of the Rome. And because of that, kyunki Romans jo the, Romans were the traditionally, they were traditionally, they liked the republic, they loved the traditions. And they never wanted the Senate to be the, and the Republic, Senate was marked by the Republic. So the Republic should be the undermined. No. As becoming the powerful, Julius Caesar emerged the dictator there, and began to exercise and his entire authority himself. And in 4700 BC, aristocracy challenged the Caesar's attempt to the absolute ruler, or कुछ aristocratic rule people who were the aristocratic, यानी कुछ royals aristocratic थे, they were the part of also administration, so they became the very much furious and the jealous of the Julius. Not only jealous, conception forged in mind, came in mind there, Julius Caesar had ended the republican system, and he is the dictator, and he must soon meet the end. Understand? So we know that Brutus was the one of the commander, Cassius and Brutus, they all formed a coalition. And ultimately, we know that how the Julius Caesar was murdered. A conspiracy was hatched against the Julius Caesar, and he was stabbed while coming out of the Senate House. He was many of the wars from the all sides on the Julius Caesar. Those who were the companions of the Julius Caesar and living around and friendly, they turned against him and started the stabbing him. So now, students, this study, so ultimately the Julius Caesar now got end, and it was a conflict between the monarchy and the republic, or a dictatorship came to end by the death of the Julius Caesar. He was trying, a basic struggle of the Republic was the resisted violently. Okay. And moreover, supporters of the Julius Caesar. Later on, we shall again mention that. So we have, so far we have studied now, and this is the last. Later on, the further incidents and the things we shall mention in the other class. Thank you very much.